Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving into Universe Sandbox 2 for a super fun experiment. First, let's zoom in on our home planet, Earth. It's spinning a bit fast, so we'll slow down the simulation to get a better look. All right, there's Earth, looking beautiful and blue as always. For our experiment, we're heading over to the Composition tab. Our goal is to see what happens when we replace Earth's oceans with something totally different, specifically sulfur dioxide. We'll use the Replace Materials option here, which lets us swap out any element, like our current water, with a new one. So, with water selected, let's swap it out for sulfur dioxide. This is where things get interesting. We'll keep the depth setting to replace only the oceans. Before we hit replace, let's just slow the simulation down a tad so we can really see the changes unfold. All right, here we go. Click, and boom! The oceans are rapidly turning a strange whitish brown. Whoa, sulfur dioxide is a notoriously toxic and poisonous gas. It looks like all of Earth's water has been replaced by this gas, turning our vibrant blue planet into something completely unrecognizable. We can see the gas mass clearly here in the composition stats. Let's switch to surface lock mode to get a closer view. And to see things even better, I'll toggle on the flashlight option. Now we're getting a clear look at our new sulfur dioxide world. To get an even clearer picture, we can turn off the clouds and atmosphere. And wow, the planet now appears a deep, rusty red. This vibrant new color is definitely a direct result of replacing our oceans with sulfur dioxide. Now let's check its habitability. As expected, the life likelihood has dropped to a flat zero. This means all life on Earth has perished, simply because our life-sustaining oceans are now highly toxic sulfur dioxide. Let's speed up the simulation and observe Earth's long-term transformation. When we turn the atmosphere off, we can see it's essentially become a massive reddish-brown sphere of sulfur dioxide. Let's actually land on the surface and see what it's like. As you can see, it's now a barren, desolate landscape. The former ocean beds are filled with what appears to be an orange-brown sulfur dioxide liquid, or perhaps a thick, vaporized form of it. No blue water in sight. The whole planet now strongly resembles Venus, with its thick, toxic atmosphere and reddish-brown surface. We'll speed up the simulation even more, now running at a full day per second. You can see the Earth Similarity Index continues to plummet. It's clearly not our home planet anymore. Notice how the land masses are starting to look different. It seems the sulfur dioxide is having a significant impact, causing the continents to appear fractured and eroded. This isn't just a liquid replacement, it's actively dissolving or transforming the very land. It's definitely consuming all the vegetation, leaving no trace of life behind. However, it's interesting to note that some green patches, particularly in what looks like South America, still persist. It's a bit unclear why these areas of vegetation remain, given the extreme changes elsewhere. Back to the global view, let's speed up the simulation again and check the temperature. It has plummeted to around minus 11 degrees Celsius. And good news, or bad depending on your perspective, Earth's orbit around the Sun remains completely stable. Even as its rotation speed seems to be decreasing, our Earth is transforming further. It's now starting to look a lot like Mars. The continents are truly becoming more and more eroded and fractured as time progresses in this harsh new environment. Major landmasses like Europe and Asia are being completely reshaped, almost crumbling. Even the poles are showing dramatic changes, appearing to detach or dissolve from the main landmass. It's hard to fully comprehend the extent of these changes, but it's clearly a destructive process. And speaking of strange observations, I still don't understand how those green patches of vegetation, particularly in what appears to be South America, are surviving all this sulfur dioxide. Seriously, if any of you know why this vegetation is still thriving in South America under these conditions, please let me know in the comments. It's truly puzzling. When we zoom in, you can clearly see these distinct green areas. They must be some form of resilient vegetation. If we tweak the visualization settings, specifically the vegetation color, we can confirm that these are indeed vegetation patches. So, is there some unknown interaction with sulfur dioxide that allows this particular vegetation to survive, or perhaps even thrive? It's baffling. We can see similar green patches popping up in other areas too, like the Philippines and Indonesia. Again, if anyone has insights into why this vegetation is able to endure, drop a comment below. Let's fast forward the simulation even more. The temperatures are now well below negative 20 degrees Celsius, and the Earth similarity score continues to fall, solidifying that this planet is completely inhospitable. It seems the prolonged exposure to sulfur dioxide eventually takes its toll. The green patches have finally disappeared, confirming that this environment is indeed deadly for all vegetation. Another thing I'm curious about, why did the continents, especially those in Eurasia, appear to get so scrambled or eroded? It's not just the oceans changing, but the land itself. If you have any theories on that, please share them in the comments.
Looking at the material properties, the boiling and melting points of sulfur dioxide are incredibly low, around minus 72 degrees Celsius. This explains why it remains stable as a liquid or gas under these extreme conditions. We can also see various surface and motion charts here, but overall, it appears the fundamental orbital dynamics remain unchanged. So, this is our final transformed Earth, a completely unique and striking appearance, with its oceans replaced by sulfur dioxide. It's quite a sight, isn't it? And that brings us to the end of today's experiment. If you enjoyed seeing Earth's dramatic transformation, please hit that like button and consider subscribing for more Universe Sandbox explorations. Let me know in the comments what wild scenarios you'd like to see next. Thanks for watching.